Very, very warm. Good morning, everyone. Welcome you all to the very, very proud privilege to us to hold this prestigious, inspirationally inclined talk event, TEDx. And it's an infinite great honor to have the most celebrated guest today. First speaker, Mr. Abhishek Sahu. Also, along with his career pursuing his passion as a photographer, a good round of applause to him. Dr. Murali Krishnagaru, Assistant Professor in Tata Institute of Social Sciences, who has done extensive work and research for the marginalized sectors. A good round of applause to him. Ms. Shravya, who is a tennis player and also a gold and silver medalist at South Asian Games. And it's a pleasure having her with us. A good round of applause to her. And the last speaker for the event today, Dr. Adira Naya. It's a pleasure having you, dental and also a spoken word poet. And the performers for the today's event, Mr. Nitish, guitarist, singer, composer himself, who has even performed in the famous movie Dear Comrade, and Ms. Kavya, versatile dancer, who has gotten many awards right from the age till date. It's equal pleasure having both of you with us today. A good round of applause to both of them. And I'm here to give a small brief about Vietnam. And I can't start talking about Vietnam without talking about our visionary chairman, Dr. Lau Rathnegaru. And his journey started in the year 1977. Whenever I have to start, tell about this person to our children, I mean our students, I say when somebody wants to become an engineer, or a doctor, when one of the parents is an engineer or a doctor, is a very relatively risk-free aspect because the process is known, the path is already laid. But when somebody wants to become an engineer, to become a doctor, to become a lawyer, civil servant, or any respectable position in a profession, when their parents are not educated, when they have not financially sound, it takes tremendous amount of hard work and dedication. And having said that, comes this man where he doesn't have money for the next meal and is just denied a job in one of the colleges. Then he said, I want to own this college. I do not want to be a normal teacher, normal engineer or a doctor. I want to be owner of this institution and help many such people like me. So it means to say, as I said, when I don't even have money to meet my basic needs for the very next day, for someone to say that, it means courage. It means a big dream. It means a great vision. So with that great vision, he has started Vietnam, and it's a huge success in 2-3 years of starting. But his dream didn't stop there. He got a little more greedy and said, when I can become successful, from nowhere, from nothing, there are many, many people like me who can also be successful, become leaders. And he started guiding, mentoring such people, and today, any of his alumni, any of his students come and tell him, sir, I become the most, I have passed the toughest UPSC exam. I have become the top politician. Then he says, you became the top civil servant of the, yes, politician of the civil servant. But you shouldn't stop there. You should try becoming the best civil servant this country has ever seen. Your work should speak for the next 50 years. That is how your dream should be. That is how he guides all his children. And his dream doesn't stop there. He not only creates or not only mentors people to be more accomplished in their respective professions, but also be very sound in their character. At the same time, they should be sound, morally, ethically. So, everybody working in Vietnam, everybody who is studying under him, who is studying now, know that he is a living example of all the values he mentions. He practices what he preaches. Hard work, dedication and passion for one's profession. For the last 43 years, I have never seen him taking a break. Even if it is a Sunday, even if it is a festival day, even when he is sick. Even he is down with the virus, he says, let me go to the college actually better. So, that's the passion he conveys to all the people working here and all the students studying here. And having achieved so much, serving so many people in these years, he still be very, very humble, very approachable and very modest. Not only that, honesty, self-respect, respecting others, everything, he is a living example. As said, he practices everything before he preaches. And I can go on and on about him, but the show must go on. So, and under his visionary leadership, me and my brother, Sri Krishnadevaraya, also member of parliament from Nagpur constituency, took the internship of Vietnam in the year 2009 and 2003 respectively. And having taken internship, today under Vietnam's umbrella, we have 18 schools. We have 5 junior colleges, 1 B.Ed. college, 1 PG. college, 3 pharmacy colleges, 6 engineering colleges and a BBA. We are one of the very few groups who have their presence right from the LKG to the post-graduation, with around 50,000 students on its roll and who are committed to serve this country. And as I head mostly the gainful sector and also today's theme is unorthodox perspective, I am just going to give a very small brief on what we do uniquely in our schools. What is unconventional about our schools, that much I am just going to go ahead. So the first thing in academics, many universities across the globe, across the world, they are saying we create knowledge. They are no longer saying we are transferring knowledge. What is the difference between creating knowledge and transferring knowledge? Creating knowledge, where they are going beyond the textbooks, going beyond what is already written, I am experimenting, I am collaborating with other knowledges, I am collaborating with industries, understanding their requirements and coming up with new formulations, new theories and new technologies. This is what creating new knowledge means. I wouldn't say we are successful 100% but we are trying it out just at the school level to create this knowledge, to help our children go beyond the textbooks, experiment on their own, practice on their own, and come up with their own formulations. At the same time, not everyone in the class is as equipped to create knowledge. There are many children in the class to reading the entire textbook is a task for them. For such children, we have to understand if there are 40 in a class, their learning types are different. Some are kinesthetically smart, some are auditory smart, some are visual smart. A teacher who is getting into the class, who is going into the class, has to be prepared to reach to that 40th student. Has to prepare some of the new teaching methodologies, new teaching and learning aids to reach to that 40th student. That is what we try to do in the terms of personalized learning. Even we have put our best foot forward to reach the 40th child, there are times for various reasons few children consistently do not do well in the exam. For them we conduct a program called Back to Basics where the teacher is personally attending to the child and working right from their basics to the current section, current class. So that is what we do in academics. Apart from the regular teaching, learning that is going on in every school. Apart from it, we all firmly believe that a sound mind lies in a sound body. So all the campuses you have seen the previous slides. The average size of all those 35 to 40 campuses is 15 acres. It goes without saying, they not only have well-equipped, spacious classrooms, but also well-equipped playgrounds for maximum level of sports and games. So this, as most of the parents will agree with me, not every child is very good in academics. They have to have other alternatives, activities, where they can pursue as a passion, like many speakers present here. They all have some or the other hidden talent. It's the responsibility of the school to bring that out and to nurture it. When we expose different activities at a very early age, it not only helps the children to excel them, to take part in those activities and excel them in the future, but also it helps them at younger age to gain confidence and to stabilize their abilities. So that is what we firmly believe and that is what we do across all the schools of Brigham. And last but not the least, every great leader today is not born out of great knowledge, but definitely with great compassion. Compassion to understand others' needs, compassion to understand others' pain, that's where most of the leaders are born. So, to create that empathy among children, the entire process, the entire curriculum, all the year-round activities and events are planned in such a way that they are connected to the people around, they are connected to the happenings around. And to further it up, and to increase their leadership skills, we also encourage our children to conduct events like parents, annual day, and all the prominent events, almost all the small events from assembly, right from morning assembly to every small event in the school, it is conducted by the children themselves. So this ensures that they participate, they nurture themselves, they develop their confidence and their leadership skills with time. So these are few things which we are doing at the school level. All of you are most welcome to give more suggestions. And beyond this, there are few special achievements which we are proud of in the last few years. The first being, Niti Aayog committee have given us 10 lakh reward to set up Atal Tinkering Lab to foster scientific temperament, to spirit of inquiry, to increase the spirit of inquiry. They have given our school this reward to set up the lab. And our school is one of those 257 schools across India. Out of 13,000 applicants, 30,000 applicants received in that year, our school is one of the few which got selected. And next TEDx event, as many know, nobody knows where one gets the motivation from. So TEDx speakers goes without saying helps all those children to know, motivate and excel in their passion, in their respective professions in the future. And the next event is SMA is an independent organization which conducts around 28 competitions in sports and games. It is conducted amongst all the Hyderabad schools, and for the last three consecutive years, Vignan has topped this competition in all the 28 sports and games competitions. And Vignan is one of the few schools which was awarded the best private school year award in the year 2005 by then Honorable Chief Minister Sri Narendra Modi. And Vignan is also a proud part of Guinness Book of World Records for its 36-hour non-stop performance. These are few of the special achievements which we had in the last few years. And apart from this, as I mentioned previously also, our vision, our chairman's vision, our institution's vision is not just to create employees, but also employers and leaders in their respective functions. These are few of the leaders in different spheres in their respective walks of life who have made, who have got international clients and also national clients. So one of them is our Minister of IT, Minister of Industries and Commerce, Ministry of Urban Development and Municipal Corporation, Mr. K. Tarak Ramarao Garu, and along with him, out of 175 constituencies in Andhra Pradesh, 4-5 of them are students of Vignan. So it's a very privileged position for each one present in Vignan. And similarly, in all other spheres, whether it be in entertainment, whether it be in sports, whether it be in business, we see our ex-students doing really well, and I wish many more to join this list in the future. And thank you all for being so patient also. Thanks for giving me this opportunity. Wish you all the success. Wishing all the success for the future, for the speakers. Thank you.